morning sun shines on the gleaming hide of a muscular ranch horse. The aroma of bacon and coffee drifts from the wood cook stove at a cow camp. Silver spurs jingle as the men and women of the West get set for another day in the saddle. From the heart of Canada's finest ranching country, this is the Spirit of the West with rancher and horse trainer Hugh McLennan and his collection of music, poetry, and conversations with the folks who live and work with horses and cattle in the Spirit of the West.
Sure nice to see those tiny, shiny, wobbly calves drying on the ground now, and they're coming in big numbers around here. Hope it's going well for you. And what does the future hold for these little guys? Well, who knows? But the Rangeland News will take a look.
A continued contraction of the nation's cattle herd is expected this year.
And wait till you hear the story we'll dig up from the vault today.
So we get the horse into the bathroom, and he said, let's put it in the tub. So we pushed and shoved and got the horse in the tub.
And the legend himself, Waddie Mitchell, graces the cowboy poetry spotlight. And on the Irvin Saddles and Western Wear horse training file, some sad news about the passing of a great horseman from Australia and some of his time-honored principles. And you'll hear a bunch of colorful stories from well-known cowboys and trainers like Kerry Kuhn, Caley Wilson, and Tammi Pate.
I saw Curt and I rode and threw my walkie-talkie at him.
And we're going to start things off with one that I love to play in the old CD deck after Cody and I have had a great day trailing yearlings at a neighboring ranch. Driving home just seems to make the grin on my face even bigger, and I turn it up loud enough that Cody's able to hear it back there in the trailer.
Sorrow behind, won't need this bitterness where I
interesting the name of that group is A Little Farther West, kind of appropriate. Well, Kerry Kuhn is a well-known Kansas horse trainer. He's traveled the world helping folks with their horses, and his YouTube videos are really great to watch, and I was really impressed the first time I watched him start a colt.
So, Kerry, your adventures over the years, horses, cattle, rugged country.
Oh, I could stand out here for hours talking about the wrecks I caused. Probably the one that stands out the most. I mean, I've had my thumb put back on from being hung up in a rope. But I was out one day with my brother doctoring some foot rot cattle. And I was riding a little stud of mine that was really, really green. And he was really, really scared of cattle. And my brother got this steer caught. And I was just going to heel him. I thought, no big deal. I'm not tied on. It doesn't matter if this colt's a little bit scared of him. So I just tracked him around, got him healed, took my dally, stretched him out. Everything was going great. Well, that steer went to bawling. All the other cattle in the pasture were over the hill behind me. As soon as they heard that one bawling, here they come. I didn't see him, but my horse did. So he spins around, and I couldn't ride him one-handed. I needed two hands to ride this rascal. He was green. He spins around and sees him. So I try to undally while my rope's stuck under the rubber on my saddle horn. And they just keep coming. So he spins, makes a full circle and just leaves. So I got a coil around my waist, and I can't get it off that saddle horn. And I'm thinking, it's going to cut me in half. Because my brother's still tied onto that steer. And it thankfully burned all the rubber off that horn, but it ripped me off that horse so hard. But there's so many things that can happen.
Oh, isn't it?
And that was just one of many, but that one probably got in my head more than any of them.
Oh, my God. I'm glad you survived that so you could go on to join us here.
Oh, that's for sure. So many things can happen, and sometimes you just don't see it coming. Maybe you should. West Coast horseman Caley Wilson will try to top that one, and something you'll want to hear about calving when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. You know, there's been a number of songs that have been written about calving, and I'm going to have one of the best of them for you after I visit with Abbotsford performance horse trainer Caley Wilson. Caley's a graduate of Olds College in Alberta, and just back last month, he rode a great horse, LHR Ray C, to a Certificate of Merit in the National Rain Cow Horse Association in Texas.
I'm glad you survived that so you could go on to join us here. But, Caley, ropes and horses and wild cattle or whatever, there's got to be some.
I've been in wreck every week almost. I just seem to bring it on myself, but... I don't know. I got all kinds. How much time we got?
As much as you want.
I'm just teasing.
We're just getting to the good stuff now.
Well, the worst hurt I ever got was going down the fence in Idaho there with a cow, and judges blew the whistle to just say that give me a new cow, because this cow kind of came in on the fight, and I started boxing it, going down the fence with it, and then they whistled me a new cow, and I'm running full out beside it, and I just went and stopped my horse when I heard the whistle. The cow's right next to me, and my spur stuck in that cow's side in the hair and rotated my leg out, and it snapped my leg in three places.
Oh, my gosh.
So that was a bad one. Well, we got others
I'm sure.
That are more exciting. But
yeah, you'd have been out of commission for a little while.
A little while, yeah. I tried to ride after a month, and obviously that wasn't too smart. It hurt bad.
Oh,
and then I waited a couple months after that again before I got on, but I'm pretty hard-headed when it comes to that. I thought it would be healed a little bit, but it wasn't.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, don't go away. Caley has another even more spectacular story coming right up. And, you know, I never like to let a calving season in the spring go by without playing this one from Jim Reeder.
I'm 3 weeks into calving time and I'm 2 weeks behind on a matrimonial payment plan evidently I had signed. My wife said next year she's gonna take care of me and Cruz. She claims she never sees me when all my calves are due. And I said, whoa, whoa,
honey, let's get something straight. If I was a four-legged critter, I'd be someone with whom you would relate. Best if I just stayed and hung around. My dinner, it was hot at 6 by 11, freezing cold. Oh, but nothing quite compared to the iceberg at the door. She said, whoa, whoa, honey, cut me a little slack. Well, I'm a lonesome girl in a lonesome world, and I want my husband back. And I said, whoa, make it up to you. When cabin time is over, I'll name the best one of the bunch after you. And I said, whoa, whoa, honey, cut me a little slack. For I'm a ranch man, and this you knew when you smiled and said, I do. And she said, whoa, now hold on, honey, let's get something straight. If I was a four-legged critter, I'd be someone with whom you would relate. Yeah, if I was a four-legged critter, I'd be someone with whom you would relate.
Come on down to McAleer Ranch, March 27th, to check out the Integrity Speckle Park sale offering. There will be yearling and two-year-old bulls, as well as purebred and commercial females, for sale from Movin's Box, Wolf Lake, and McAleer Ranch. All animals sell via DLMS Farmgate, timed auction. The sale closes on March 27th at 6 Central Standard Time. Supper and hospitality will be provided. Contact Dustin at 306-228-1498 for more information. We look forward to seeing you March 27th at the McAleer Ranch, south of Unity, Saskatchewan. Well, when I asked Kerry Wilson for another story, it didn't take him long to come up with one.
Yeah, there's another time I had an animal rope there, and just a cow, a muley there, and we're just treating her there for foot rot, and just was on a little Appaloosa horse. And it was, I ran into the fellow, and that horse must have been just 4 years old at the time, and I ran into the fellow here at this show, and that horse is 18 now. Just, that was a while ago.
Yeah.
But anyhow, that's why I'm thinking of that story, riding that horse. And it's the only time I've ever been jerked off of a horse with the cinches done up tight and landed on the ground in the saddle with both cinches done up with nothing broke.
Holy smokes.
So what happened was I had her stretched out there, and I was waiting for my buddy to heel her, and he kept missing, and I didn't want this cow to choke down, so I kept sliding rope at her, and she was standing there kind of a little bit choking, tongue out, and my horse was a little tired at the end of the day. And then she started running towards me, and I was pretty green then, like didn't have a lot of experience, and she got a front leg over the rope as she kind of came and created slack, so I was either going to have to chase after and kick up and coil up and shorten up, or else just start backing up and let them take the jerk. Well, I started backing. It was a split second decision. Started backing, and when she hit, everything just came free. And I came right over that horse, and I landed in the ground in my saddle. My dally popped. I looked back, my horse is behind me standing there, and I'm in the saddle and look like, oh, everything broke. There was nothing broke.
Wow, you slid right off.
Yeah. And he somehow stepped out of the cinches, and I was in the ground. And the cow ran off with my rope.
Man, that's a way to untack your horse.
Well, I've never done that for sure. Well, we're going to dive down into the vault for another incredible story, this time from Gerald Miller, when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West.
Stories from the vault, from the Spirit of the West. This is where we dig deep for some of the most amazing stories from the folks who bring some heartwarming, knee-slapping, spellbinding episodes.
It's hard to top this one from Alberta rancher Gerald Miller.
This is a story I heard a while ago. I don't know who started telling it, and I don't know where it come from. But I've enjoyed it so doggone much I wanted to share it with you folks. It's called There's a Dead Horse in the Bathtub. I was driving home late one night and drove by my neighbor's place. As I was going by, I looked over and I happened to see his pickup with the lights on backed up to the house. While thinking there was a problem, I stopped in. And as I was walking up, there stood old Bill beside his pickup. I said, "Bill, have you got a problem?" Well, Bill says, "Boy, am I ever glad to see you." He says, "I need some help." I said, "What do you need a hand with, Bill?" "Well," he said, "you look in the back of the pickup there." He said, "There's a dead horse in there, and I need to get it up on the porch." Well, I looked at Bill and thought, what the heck, so I pushed and pulled and shoved, and sure enough, we got the dead horse up on the porch. We just get it up there, and Bill says, "Let's keep going." So we pushed it in the front room door and pushed it across the living room. I looked at Bill, and he pointed up the stairs. So we're a shoving and a pushing, getting this horse up the stairs, and one of the hooves fell over and banged against the wall. Now old Bill's face just went white. He said, "Shh." He said, "You don't want to wake her up. Don't do that again." So very carefully, we pushed and pulled and got the horse up the stairs. And I said, "Where to, Bill?" He said, "Into the bathroom." So we get the horse into the bathroom, and he said, "Let's put it in the tub." So we pushed and shoved and got the horse in the tub. Got him looking real comfortable. So we went back downstairs and sat down in the living room, and I looked at Bill, and Bill said, "Yeah," he said, "I suppose you're wondering why we put a dead horse in the bathtub." I said, yeah, I kind of am. "Well," Bill said, he said, "it's my wife." He said, "She knows everything." He said, "I went to town one day, and I come home and said, guess what?" She said, "You bought a new truck." Sure enough, he said, "I bought a new truck." Another day, he said, "I come home and said, guess what?" She said, "You bought a bull." Sure enough, he said, "I'd bought a bull." He said, "That woman knows everything." But he said, "Tomorrow morning, she's going to get up. She's going to go into the bathroom. She's going to stay there for a minute. Then she's going to come running back in the bedroom. And she's going to say, guess what? And I'm going to say, there's a dead horse in the bathtub."
Horse Expo Canada, the largest equine trade show in Western Canada at Westerner Park, Red Deer, Alberta, April 15th to 17th, 2022. Three outstanding horsemen will start three promising colts. Your chance to learn from the finest horsemen and women in the business. Buy a VIP ticket and your lanyard lets you bypass the line and go right into the show. Access to the VIP area, including a full bar and special VIP menu, available till March 15th. See horseexpocanada.ca or call 1-833-425. March the 5th, 1921. That was the day a legend was born. His name was Casey Tibbs, and our dear friend Rusty Richards, a longtime tenor with the Sons of the Pioneers, great horseman, wrote a fine book on Casey's life. The title is Born to Ride. And Rusty and Casey were best pals. They rodeoed for years together. Rusty shod Casey's horses. You can order the book at Amazon. And here's a fine tribute to this guy from Ian Tyson.
For 40s in South Dakota, America's young and free. John Tibbs raised up 10 children, one turned out to be the wildest young bronc fighter who ever bucked down the line. Just 19 when he won the world in 1949. Yeah, Casey, he was different, like the great ones always are. They march to a different drummer, they follow a different star. From the Bronx and the chutes to the downtown ladies, everybody knew it was 4th of July with the big blue sky. Casey was coming through. And the shafts were purple, the Cadillac was purple, the sky was 1950 blue. Green was the color of the greenback dog. He rode them bronks with a hoop and a horn. Casey, rainbow rider, there'll never be enough. shots were purple, the Cadillac was purple, the sky was 1950 blue, green was the color of the greenback dollar, he rode them ropes with a hoop and a holler, Casey the Rainbow Rider, there'll never be another like you. Shots were
Rangeland News from the Spirit of the West, a roundup of issues and events from the world of agriculture.
Expansion and contraction seems like it has a lot of implications. Barbed wire fences get tighter when it gets real cold, and they get slacker when it's hot. Guitar strings are very sensitive to temperature changes. That's why they can be perfectly in tune at the start of the set, but if the temperature changes quite a bit, they can be way off by the end of the set. My little brother Jim really gets annoyed when mine goes out of tune. But how about expansion and contraction of the North American cow herd? Here's Rod Bain.
A continued contraction of the nation's cattle herd is expected this year. USDA livestock analyst Shale Shagum.
We are looking at expectations of a continued decline of probably 1% to 2% in the cattle inventory during 2022. So that would then make the end of 2022 the fourth year of contraction in the cattle sector.
Shagum at this year's USDA Ag Outlook Forum said this means tighter availability of cattle for placement in feedlots.
The total number of cattle available was about 1.6% below a year earlier.
This translates to an expected year-over-year decline in commercial beef production of 2%. Declines in cattle inventory and beef production also indicate
higher calf prices. We are forecasting prices of fed cattle in 2022 to be about $161 a hundredweight, compared to $157 last year. And I'll note that $161 is the highest price since 2015.
I'm Rod Bain reporting for the U.S. Department of Agriculture in Washington, D.C.
Horse owners near Saskatoon are urged to keep a lookout for equine strangles. Following recent cases of this highly contagious disease, strangles, as you probably know, is a bacterial infection of the upper respiratory tract caused by a streptococcus bacteria, not a virus, a bacteria. And as the slightly sinister name suggests, symptoms relate to abnormal breathing and difficulty swallowing, and other symptoms can include a high fever, loss of appetite, nasal discharge, and lymph node abscesses, and horses that are carriers can be asymptomatic. And Dr. Valentina Regno of the Western College of Veterinary Medicine said she's not surprised to see the Saskatoon area cases, and she said there's not a specific reason for it. Studies have shown that the bacteria that causes strangles can live in a bucket of water for several weeks. Fresh water and clean buckets, of course, are critical for prevention. A perceived global shortage of veterinarians is creating an urban-rural companion large animal bidding war for salary incentives and work-life balance to attract new applicants. The global debate continues, and are there too few students choosing food animal medicine, or are there enough but they're just not choosing to work in certain areas, just like family doctors might not choose to work in a certain area? And it seems it's a combination of both, says Dr. Jeff Wichtel, the dean of Ontario Veterinary College. And he said another factor is underestimating the amount of spending on pets 5 to 10 years ago when making workforce predictions. He said we've been caught flat-footed. All of the traditional problems of getting vets to locate in underserved parts of Ontario have now been compounded by the worldwide shortage of veterinarians and technicians. Well, unionized conductors and train yard service staff with Canadian Pacific Railway have voted in favor of a strike which could begin possibly this week, although they may have solved it by the time you hear this. I hope so. A strike vote was conducted through February and went 96.7% in favor of strike action if necessary. And the vote originally was to run until February 21st, as ballots went out starting February 1st. but it was later extended to February 28th because of so many ballots being delayed in the mail. Yeah, I can understand mail delays, all right. The Big Horse Expo Canada, happening at the Westerner and Red Deer, April 15th to 17th, and they're doing a giveaway running currently. Anybody who purchases a weekend pass from now until March 31st will be entered in the draw to win a $1,000 shopping spree at the trade show. And there'll be a runner-up $100 spree, actually three of them, and all the rules are at horseexpocanada.ca. Ah, we're sure looking forward to getting in the old red McLennan Ranch pickup and heading out to Red Deer, meeting all our old friends again. I will be the voice of the Trainers Showdown, and hope we can do lots and lots of visiting there. And we're happy to announce, of course, the 9th annual Top Gun Horse Auction on Saturday, April the 9th, the preview on April the 8th. And you can see their website, topgunhorsesales.com, for more information. And we want to emphasize it is a live event at the Cal Nash Event Center, Ponoka, Alberta. And you will also be able to bid online if you choose to do that. Get all the details again at topgunhorsesales.com. Next regular cattle sale at the BC Livestock Co-op's Kamloops Yards is March 22nd and another one April 5th. Lots of special bull sales coming up at the yards as well. You can get the details at bclivestock.bc.ca, and that's, of course, where you can see the sales streaming live. Meanwhile, at the Innisfail Auction Market, regular cattle sales every Wednesday, and there's a pre-sort feeder sale on Monday, March the 21st. The calves are delivered and sorted Sundays. To book your calves, you can call Danny, Mark, or Dwayne at 1-800-710-3166 and see InnisfailAuctionMarket.com. Okay, now the final item. And amazing to see that the stores are already starting to put out all kinds of fancy camping gear on display. And boy, you know, folks just seem willing to spend a lot of money on that stuff. Camping, that's where you can spend a fortune to live like a homeless person for a few days. And that's the Rangeland News coming up on the Urban Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, some life lessons from a great horseman, and Tammi Pate talks about why she threw a two-way radio at her husband, Curt, when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. The Irvin Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File is coming right up, and we'll share some of the gems of wisdom from a great Australian horseman who's ridden across the Great Divide. First, though, way up north. Here's an updated version on our Spirit of the West farewell cruise. After 19 years of hosting the finest people you could ever meet in some of the most amazing places you could ever be, Billy and I will be stepping back after this one, and we really want to make it two things: simple, uncomplicated, and the best experience you can have. Ah, we love Alaska and all it has to offer. Cruising the spectacular Inside Passage, touring Juneau, historic Skagway, and the amazing Red Dog Saloon, and trying to get the guys to come back out of there. The White Pass Rail Tour on the Trail of the Gold Rush. Lots of live Western music, stories, cowboy poetry, sing-alongs, and so much more. And we'll kick it all off with a special show with the amazing Western Spirit Band right here at the McLennan Ranch. And then we take you to spectacular Sun Peaks, where we spend the night, then down to the ocean for a night in a spectacular waterfront hotel before boarding the luxurious and brand new Holland America Koningsdam. Now, this is important. If you would like to join us, please reserve your spot as soon as possible by calling 1-800-530-0131. Sure hope you can come along and share in the good time.
Now it's time for the Horse Training File, brought to you by Irvine Tack and Western Wear, Canada's largest Western store.
Here at Irvin Tack and Western Wear, their boot room and back room is stocked and stacked with the top brand names.
Shh, I'm doing inventory. 258.
Western styles for cowboys and cowgirls. Work boots, muck boots, hiking boots.
60.
Even boots for your cattle and horses.
Nice try, funny guy. 261.
Whoa, she's good. Shop online at urbans.ca or stop in today, exit 305 off Highway 2 by Crossview,
Canada's largest Western store.
Last week, you heard a great conversation I had with the Australian stockman, horseman, and clinician Ron Wall. And after that show ran, I found out that this much-loved Australian had passed away after a short battle with cancer in September of 2020. And among the many tributes that came in then, some of them said he was possibly one of the best horsemen Australia has ever seen. And while he was a successful competitor, his main business was teaching others the tricks of the trade, holding schools across the country and beyond, and providing services to some of Australia's biggest cattle companies. And one of his colleagues, Rick Young, said, "I don't think we'll see a person of Ronnie's natural ability for a long time, if ever again." He's traveled the world, he's been invited to some of the biggest events in the world, and he's won nearly every event in Australia. There are hundreds of people that he's helped, and there are hundreds more advanced horsemen that he's also helped. And I kind of thought this would be fitting to include some of Ron's horsemanship principles today. 1, don't annoy the horse. For sure. 2, ride the horse you are on, not the one you think you're on. 3, when something doesn't work, stop doing it. And 4, with a horse, like in dating, consent is required. Number 5, if the horse does not want to be with you, well, there is a reason. And number 6, the more you know, the gentler you are. Number 7, horses don't wear wristwatches, and as a result, they always have time. And number 8, intelligent action always brings intelligent reactions. If not, it's you and not the horse. Number 9, it's not the bit that's the problem. It's the hands operating it. And number 10, don't annoy the horse. And for Irvin Saddles and Western Wear, that's the horse training file. Our horses sure love it. That's their daily feeding of Hoffman's Horse Ration. And you can find out all about what's in it and why it works so well at hoffmanshorseproducts.com. The 2022 Top Gun Spring Horse Sale runs April 9th at the CalNash Event Center, Ponoka, Alberta. This is the best place to find your next grade horse for any discipline. Ranch horses, team fenders, all kinds of rope horses, kids' horses, horses for mounted shooting, trail riding, and more. A 100% live auction, come one, come all. Preview is April the 8th at 5 p.m. Sale Saturday, April 9th at high noon. Internet bidding is available as well. Check the catalog to get set up to bid online in live time. For more information, call Jordan Dodds, 403-783-0246. Come on down to McAleer Ranch, March 27th, to check out the Integrity Speckle Park sale offering. There will be yearling and two-year-old bulls, as well as purebred and commercial females, for sale from Movin's Bots, Wolf Lake, and McAleer Ranch. All animals sell via DLMS Farmgate, timed auction. The sale closes on March 27th at 6 Central Standard Time. Supper and hospitality will be provided. Contact Dustin at 306-228-1498 for more information. We look forward to seeing you March 27th at the McAleer Ranch, south of Unity, Saskatchewan. You will hear from Tammi Pate, the wife of the well-known horseman Curt Pate, and why she threw a two-way radio at Curt while they were gathering cattle with the family. But first, Randy Houston's new album, In Times Like These, is really generating a lot of interest, and I've played a few tracks from it in the last month or two. Here's another one, The Ride of My Life.
Spectators pay to witness a wreck, or the bucking horse ballet on the hurricane deck. There's no one to watch, 'cause I'm out here alone, If the outcome is bad, they'll gather my bones. My foot's in the stirrup, his cheek to my side. I'm one step away from the ride of my life. My neck is too stiff, I refuse to yield. Son of the land of the leather and steel, this horse is my siren, beauty that blinds. The next wheeling victim, I'm standing in line. My foot's in the stirrup, his cheek to my side. I'm one step away from the ride of my life. I've been here before and I chew on the pain. This time will be different, my stubborn refrain. Maybe insanity, my driving force. The spring gets tighter inside of my horse. My foot's in the stirrup, his cheek to my side. And I'm one step away from the ride of my life. Ending is written on blank canyon walls, like whispers of echoes of dry waterfalls. The shock of the lightning, the feel of the flash, the phoenix reborn from breathing the ash. My feet in the stirrups, a leg on each side. Sit back and enjoy the ride of my life. My feet in the stirrups, a leg on each side. Sit back and enjoy the ride of my life.
So I guess that means we're going to have to wait for Randy Houston's next CD to find out how that ride went. Well, you know, I first heard about the great horseman Curt Pate from Don Edwards when Don was appearing in the movie The Horse Whisperer with Robert Redford, and Curt and Buck Brannaman were handling most of the horsework for the movie. And then we met Curt's wife, Tammi, while after that we've had many great conversations with the two of them. And now, a few years ago, Billy and I tried using walkie-talkies, little two-way portable radios, when we were gathering cattle in a big range permit, and we found actually they were quite a help. But it didn't turn out that well for Tammi and Curt.
So we had extra kids all that summer, and I only had two rules. They couldn't kill rattlesnakes with the end of their rope, and they couldn't pack a gun to shoot gophers if there was more than two kids. those were the rules.
The only two rules.
The only two rules. Everything else they could do. They thought for themselves. I have a good story of that summer and horsemanship. And we had been on this ranch, and there were big pastures. Some of them were like, one was 9 sections, and one was 6 sections. And we'd been moving cattle, and it was real rough country. And if it rained, it got real slick and real gumbo-y. And so I had decided with all these kids and for safety, I wanted to get walkie-talkies. And everything had been going great, and kids had always got cattle where they were supposed to be and everything. And
I didn't want the walkie-talkies.
Kurt did not want the walkie-talkies, but I thought for safety we needed to have them. So we were out to moving cattle, and Ryle and I, our son, we got to fighting over the walkie-talkies. And so I called Kurt on his walkie-talkie and asked him to tell Ryle that I was right. And Kurt, he was like, I'm not listening to this. And he turned his walkie-talkie off. And so we brought our cattle and saw each other. And today I was able to contain my emotions. But on that day, I was pretty hot. So I saw Kurt, and I rode and threw my walkie-talkie at him for turning his walkie-talkie off. And he said, Tammi, he said, but think about this. He said, the kids have been thinking for themselves. They've been getting the job done, and now we have these walkie-talkies, and no one will think for themselves. No one wants to make a decision.
You have to have a committee meeting before you do anything.
Yes, and you're micromanaging, mm-hmm. and they're second-guessing themselves. And he said, you know, it's just better off without him. And truly, you know, once I got over my little mad, it's true.
Yeah.
That lifestyle, and while it can be dangerous and safety is very important to me, it was the best upbringing and the gift that we could give our kids in decision-making and confidence and running their own ranch someday is the freedom to make decisions and either, you know, make maybe not so good ones or very good ones, but work through them.
Mm. So you use them now, the walkie-talkies?
No, we don't.
As a matter of fact, that walkie-talkie's
still out there in the pasture, she said, before I cut her off. Well, still to come, another great classic song of the West and the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Dave Stamey has the classic Song of the West this week coming right up. Waddie Mitchell is in the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight, and these are the High Country Cowboys.
Well, we got the herd bedded for the night. My work's done for the day. I ride up to where we are camped, about a quarter mile away. Oh, a pot of coffee is brewing, beans and bacon smell real fine. As I climb down from my cow pony to rest them bones of mine. Well, the trail boss comes up to me, says, what are you doing here? Don't you know it's your turn to stand guard, so get out there with them steers. You can wait and have your victuals when your night watch is all through. So forget about your coffee, cause a storm's starting to brew. Old cold coffee, I know that's what I'll get. Some old burnt beans, some bacon fat, and an old dried out biscuit. Old cold coffee, this is my day to lose. I'm just a lonesome cowboy, got the old cold coffee blues.
Well, I get back where the cattle are and the thunder rolls around. I left my slicker back at camp as the rain starts pouring down. Well, I get chilled deep down in my bones and the wind blows in my face. As I wait for 3 long hours more for someone to take my place. Well, the moon finally comes back in sight, my relief rides down the hill. And as I ride back up to camp, hope there's some grub left still. Well, the fire's nearly burned itself out and the coffee's getting cold. The beans were left out in the rain and the biscuits growing mold.
Old cold coffee, I know that's what I'll get. Some old burnt beans, some bacon fat, and an old dried out biscuit. Old cold coffee, this is my day to lose. I'm just a lonesome cowboy, got the old cold coffee blues.
Well, the cookie comes along and says, why on earth were you so late? Now hurry up and eat your grub and don't forget to wash your plate. Well, I guess this just wasn't my day, and there's one thing that's true. When things go wrong, they sure go wrong, got the old cold coffee blues.
Old cold coffee, I know that's what I'll get. Some old burnt beans, some bacon fat, and an old dried out biscuit. Old cold coffee, this is my day to lose. I'm just a lonesome cowboy, got the old cold coffee blues. Odelay, odelay, yay, odelay.
Yeah, three cowboy brothers from Montana. I always enjoy their stuff, the High Country Cowboys. And I don't know, nobody really seems to know, I don't think, who wrote this classic Western song. It's been recorded by just about everybody. Don Edwards, Ian Tyson, even Pete Seeger, and so many more. I kind of like this version from Dave Stamey.
Ride through the lonely night, ride all through the day. Keep the herd moving on, moving on. like the morning star, cheeks like a rose. Laura was a pretty girl, God Almighty knows. Weep all ye stormy night, dark is the sky. Wish I'd stayed in Abilene, I was mighty warm and dry. Weep all ye little rains, wail winds wail, all alone. Ride through the lonely night, ride all through the day. Keep the herd moving on, just moving on its way. Weep all ye little rains away.
Now in the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight, the one and only Waddie Mitchell.
There ain't nothing like the feeling that you get down deep inside as you trot out in the morning when you've hired on to ride. Your mount's enthusiastic, and the air is crisp and new, and there's lively conversation going on amongst the crew. There's some bridle crickets chirping, jingle bobs tap out a tune on one side. The sun is rising, just ahead there sets the moon. Shadows high trot there beside you, elongated, keeping pace, reassuring you ain't hobbled by restricted time or space. Out in front, the boss is posting to the same beat as his song, and the realization hits you, you're right where you belong. It's then you start appreciating you're on trails where few have trod, and you wonder how you ever doubted if there really is a God. Atop a ridge, the boss reins in, so we all gather up around. It's from here he'll call the circle, so you step off to the ground, loosen up your latigo, air your pony's back. You arrange again the blankets, then you realign your cat. Then you mount back up to get dropped off, check to see who's on each side. You're glad that you're a cowboy, and you feel this twinge of pride. You ate breakfast by the Coleman, then hurried round to beat the sun. You've got 11 miles behind you, but it's here the work's begun. Now, in town, when folks must travel to their workplace every day, it's said that they're commuting to their job to earn their pay. They'll choke in crazy traffic jams, fight for seats on bus or train. It's a wonder that this ritual doesn't drive them all insane. We too, I guess, commute to work as the job at hand dictates, but we commune while we're commuting. What a difference that makes.
Guitar of Rich O'Brien in the background. Oh boy, I've recited that one more than once as we're trotting out on the morning, heading for the cattle. Well, thank you so much for making the ride today. And as always, thanks to our great support crew, Mark and Kathy McMillan. Be sure and check the latest issue, Canadian Cowboy Country Magazine. Just got some terrific reading in it, and I hope you can check out our YouTube channel and watch for all of our past programs and this one with some great video put together by our support guy, Mark McMillan. And the links to that and our podcast are right there on our website, hugh-mclennan.com. Till next week, I'm Hugh McLennan. Hope to see you down the trail somewhere real soon.